Hi, I'm Ben Graham. Welcome to our Applied Data Science trainings in the Security and Political Economy Lab. These trainings will take you all the way from raw beginner up through beautiful visualization of regression results with a lot of data management and pretty picture making along the way. But why should you bother? Why develop applied data science skills? These trainings were originally designed to help folks become indispensable research assistants and contribute to cutting edge social science research projects in our lab. And they're very good at doing that. But learning how to manage data and create beautiful visualizations is also a very efficient way to land a high paying job after graduation, to gain admissions to top social science PhD programs, and to have a positive impact on the world. We've solicited input on these trainings from a lot of places, including my counterparts at Facebook and Zoom and Talus Analytics and the State Department and RAND. So we've designed a curriculum that can take you a lot of different places. When we unlock the meaning in data and communicate it clearly to other people, we allow NGOs and firms and governments to make better decisions, to find ways to motivate people to do good things and deter them from doing bad things. We unlock our ability to change the world. All right. One reason you can get a high-paying job doing this work is that data science skills are pretty new and they're scary to a lot of folks. So these skills remain scarce and the price remains high. I think you'll find, though, it's actually a bit easier to learn this material than you would expect, and you don't actually have to be good at math to do this work. In fact, if you struggled in math classes in high school or you don't view yourself as a numbers person, this is evidence you might actually be better than average at explaining quantitative information to other people, right? Most of whom are not numbers people. The real unicorns in this field aren't the math geniuses necessarily. They're the folks who can both make meaning from data and communicate that meaning simply and elegantly. And that's what we're going to train you to do. There is so much knowledge and understanding locked away in reams of messy data hidden from our puny little human brains, right? If we can tidy up that data, we can conduct analysis and unlock those secrets, right? And if we can make elegant pictures, we can communicate that new knowledge to our fellow humans in a way they can actually receive. Because pictures are really where it's at for communicating with humans. Tell someone a number like the GDP per capita of Rwanda was $250 in 2000 and it's $800 today. And that sounds good. It sounds like it's going up, but it's a little too abstract to really understand. So if you show someone a picture of what a kitchen sink looks like in a family that makes $250 a year and what a kitchen sink looks like for a family that makes $800 a year, that really hits home, right? Those are different lives. These pictures, by the way, they're from the Dollar Street Project, which you should really check out. All right. So, you know, these trainings, they start with intro to R, but we move pretty quickly into data management. And data management is that proverbial 80% of the iceberg that sits under the water. You may have taken a statistics class or two in your life. And if you did, you probably worked with example data sets. They're already in these nice little rectangular spreadsheets where every row is an observation and every column is a variable and there's no missing values. There's no weird cells with a note crammed in where the value should be or three values where there should be one. So you spend all your time just talking about how to analyze the data and work with data that's so tidy it already sparkles. And that's great. And analysis is fun and cool. But when we work with data in the real world, we spend most of our time slogging away, trying to clean up messy, gnarly data sets and reshape them and merge them together and do all this intense wrangling and manipulation to set up the data for that analysis in the first place, right? And we're going to teach you how to do that. Once you're good at it, you are suddenly the most favorite, wonderful person in every data-driven organization you're a part of, right? Because you have the power to take that messy, confusing data and render it clean and tidy and ready to analyze. And then as promised, we will also make beautiful things, right? We will move beyond the mundane and into the artistic, right? And, you know, this may not be art in the Frida Kahlo sense, but we really can take quantitative information and communicate it both clearly and beautifully. And last, you know, why are we doing this in R in particular, right? We use R in the Spec Lab because it's free, it's flexible, and it's powerful. It plays nicely with SQL and Python. It's okay if that means nothing to you right now. But it's also really nice for the folks we train in the lab because R isn't just used in academia. It's also used a lot in tech. It's used a lot by NGOs. It's used a lot in finance. So folks who leave the lab, right, sure, they go into PhD programs in the social sciences, or they go and they do social science research at places like RAND or the Federal Reserve or the State Department. But we also have lab alums at Apple and Facebook and Amazon and Vanguard, you know. So the skills we take, the skills that we're teaching you in this curriculum, right, they can take you a lot of different places. And here we go. In the next video you see, we're going to be opening up our studio and we're going to be writing some code. Looking forward to doing this with you all.